Morning, good morning. Know how this story ends. I'm gonna see your victory. I'm gonna see your victory. Cause the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see your victory. I'm gonna see your victory. Cause the battle belongs to you, Lord. Hey, hey, good morning, good morning. See your victory, for the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see your victory. I'm gonna see your victory. How many of you are gonna see the victory of the Lord? How many of you believe that the battle belongs to God? The battle belongs to God, hallelujah. Every battle that you're facing right now, hallelujah. Oh, he's almighty. He's strong to save every battle, every battle. Somebody say, every battle belongs to God. Hallelujah. The enemy meant for evil, and he's turning no good. He turned it for good. God takes what the enemy meant for evil, you guys, and he turns it for good. Hallelujah. He takes what the enemy meant for evil, and he turns it around for our good. Good morning, Mika. Good morning, Sevilla. Everything that the enemy thought was going to kill you, everything the enemy thought was going to destroy you, everything the enemy thought was going to take you out, everything the enemy thought was going to put you at your lowest point, everything the enemy thought was going to keep you in depression, that was going to keep you oppressed, everything the enemy thought that was going to keep you stressed out beyond measure, everything the enemy thought that was going to keep you in anxiety, everything the enemy thought was going to keep your mind in bondage, everything the enemy thought was going to keep you entangled to the things of this world, everything the enemy thought was going to keep you discouraged and keep you downtrodden, everything the enemy meant for evil, God is turning it around for your good. If you believe that, I need you to say glory to God. I need you to say, God, I thank you for turning it around for my good. Lord, I thank you for being my savior. I thank you for being my rescuer. I thank you for being Lord of Lords. And I thank you for being Kings of Kings. For you are the only God. You're the only God. You're the true and living God. You're the God of Isaac. You're the God of Jacob. You're the God of Abraham. If you did it for them, God, you will do it for me. God, I thank you that you are my deliverer. Hallelujah. God, you are my deliverer. Hallelujah, God. I thank you for the victory on this morning. I thank you, God, because we come into a fixed fight on this morning. God, you've already fixed the fight. God, you've already won the war. You've already won the battle. I thank you that you're already working for my good. You're working on my behalf, God. I'm not concerned about what it looks like. I'm not concerned about what's going on around me. I'm only concerned about the word of God. I keep my eyes on the word of God. I keep my eyes on God. I will look to the hills from which cometh my help, knowing that my help comes from God. What is my help? My strength comes from God. Oh, my security comes from God. My confidence comes from God. Who I am, my identity comes from God. I look to him for everything that I need, everything that I desire. I look to God. Hallelujah. Hey, 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 hey. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, glory be to God. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Friday Faith-Filled Prayer. Faith-Filled Prayer, we're praying to God this morning. We have the faith for the faith to believe that God is a healer, that God is a deliverer, that God is enough. God is enough when it comes to idolatry. This morning, we're praying against idolatry. We're praying against witchcraft. We're praying against anything that is taking and drawing our attention away from God and drawing our attention toward other things that are not pleasing to God or toward other things that God very well may have blessed us with. And we've now become consumed by those things, and we're now treating those things like idols. Those things can be our husbands, our children, our job, our money, our habits, our is this anything? It could be anything or person. We want to pray this morning that God is enough, that our confidence is in him, that we are so assured that God is enough for us, and we stop seeking outside influences and external things, and we begin to seek ye first the kingdom of God and all of his righteousness, and all other things will be added to him, that we don't dibble and dabble into witchcraft and into other things, sorcery and other things that is not God ordained, other things that are against the word of God. It's one thing to be entangled in something and not know it, but it's another thing to be entangled in something and know you're entangled and know that what you're doing is not worthy of God's praise. Know that it's not glorifying God. Hallelujah. We're praying against the works of the flesh on this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, Masa. Yay. We're praying against the works of the flesh. And the scripture reads, I'm going to read a scripture. We're going to pray and part of the works of the flesh is idolatry and witchcraft. My battles. Hey. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanliness, lasciviousness, idolatry and witchcraft. And next time we're going to pray against adultery and fornication, all that stuff too. Hallelujah. In order for us to not fall victim to any of these things, in particular today, because we're talking and praying about idolatry and witchcraft, we must be our flesh must be crucified. We must get our flesh under control. Somebody say, I got to get it under control. We must get our flesh under control. And we must refuse to allow the space for any false god to come into our lives, any false god to come into our homes. There is nothing or no one we should be worshiping beyond, more than outside of God. God is the only God. Galatians 5, 19 through 20. The word idolatry is from the Greek word edilotria, and edilotria, which means the worship of idols. However, it is compound of the words idion, and latria. The word ilion is the Greek for made idol. It's a man-made idol, a heathen edifice, a pagan statue, or an image of a false god. I remember long ago, my dad used to have all these little clowns, and my grandmother used to have like these little images. Some of you guys may still have it, or your grandparents or parents may have it. Little figures of prayer hands, little figures of angels, little figures of just like little things, right? And if we're not too careful, those little figures, little things, we begin to collect those things. We begin to believe that those things have meaning and they mean more than what they really are. I'm not saying all the time that there's something wrong with having a statue or having an image in your house. But what I am saying is that if that image is not representative of God, number one, and then number two, if that image is becoming your idol, if you find yourself serving, if you would, or praising or loving on that image more than you love God, more than outside of you loving God, and that could be you collecting it, you having to have a need for it, you wanting it, and things of that nature. Such idols were offense to God in the Old Testament, and they were forbidden to believers in the New Testament. God's hatred of idols is clearly demonstrated in 1 Samuel 5, 1 through 4. Somebody write that down. 1 Samuel 5, 1 through 4. I'm not sure if you're familiar with the scripture or the story, but it talks about the God, the Dagon God. Remember that Dagon statue that they were worshiping and that they were serving? It was the Ark in Ashdod and Ekron, all right? After the Philistines had captured the Ark of God, they took it from Ebenezer to Eshon. Then they did something else. They carried the Ark into Dagon's temple and set it beside Dagon. And what that was saying is that the Ark of God is the same value, if you would, or the same measure as this pagan god or this image, this idol image. And when the people of Ashdod rose early the next day, there was Dagon fallen on his face on the ground before the ark of the Lord. They took Dagon and put him back into his place. But the following morning when they rose, there was Dagon fallen on his face on the ground before the ark of the Lord. His heads and his hands had been broken off and were lying on the threshold. Only his body remained. And what that tells me is that we cannot serve any other God. If we try to serve any other God, God will destroy it. He will destroy it. That's, I don't know how to say that in any other term. Okay. Now, when we talk about witchcraft, Jesus promises us in Matthew 6:33, we're going to put that scripture. We're going to pray in just like 1 or 2 minutes. I really just wanted to give you a foundation before we start praying. We have to make sure that our focus remains on Jesus, and our primary focus of our life is him. He is our primary focus of life. So when we start to do things and we start to say things that are not lining up with the scripture, we have to repent. And if you don't know what the scripture is, because you may not have been studying the scripture, you may not be aware of the scripture, you may not be versed in the scripture like that. This is the perfect time during this time of a worldwide pandemic for us to get into our word more. How many of you have had the opportunity to get into your word more? How many of you have had the opportunity to get to know God even the more? Hallelujah. This was the time to do that. So God isn't against us possessing any of the things that he's blessed us with. Like we mentioned, right? Our family, our parents, our children, our friends, our job, vision, profession, possessions, school, church, activities, personal talents. But God is against any of those things possessing us. And we have to repent on today if we've allowed things to possess us. If we've gotten so caught up on things, on fame, if we've gotten so caught up on our businesses, where we want our businesses to go, what we want our businesses to be, we have to repent on putting ministry before him. We're so focused on ministry is not necessarily God, but it is a byproduct, if you would, or a benefit from serving God, right? We're faithful and we're faithful and we're effective in ministry, right? But ministry is not God per se, so we can't worship the ministry. Oh, right, I need this many speaking engagements and, you know, just so obsessed. Nothing wrong with liking or wanting those things. We cannot become obsessed. So refuse to allow your flesh to take you down the road of self-worship, the worship of family or worship of material things to that extent. Witchcraft. Paul lists this next as one of the works of the flesh. The word witchcraft is from the word pharmakia. Pharmakia, the Greek word for medicines or drugs that inhibits a person's personality or change their behavior. These things are called mind-altering drugs, because witchcraft, is when you're dabbling in things, this is tangible things, right, that you can, that your behavior, your mindset can be influenced or altered by these things. The Greek word pharmakia is where we get the word pharmaceutical drugs or the word pharmacy. This word was used in connection with sorcery, magic, or witchcraft. Y'all heard what I said? So we cannot dabble in those things, y'all. Hallelujah. The question is asked, but why was this word used in connection with witchcraft, and why would Paul use this word to depict the works of the flesh? The response is, when the Church of Jesus Christ was being established in the first century, paganism ruled the Roman Empire. These were dark, demonic, pagan religions, of which one prominent feature was the use of drugs to alter the state of one's mind. So what witchcraft is designed to do is to alter, that means change or transform the state of your mind, and not in a good way, because it's a dark thing. Hallelujah. It's a dark thing. So we want to get rid of those things on today.
We want to remove those images from our homes. We want to renew our mind and the word of God so that we're not serving any of those images and so that we're not into any form of witchcraft. And for some families, witchcraft has been going on for generations to generations to generations. And you know that maybe your grandmother, great-grandmother, great-great-grandmother or somewhere down the line, they practice or they were into witchcraft, and you may find yourself doing the same thing. So, Father in heaven, Lord, we thank you for this day. Hallelujah. Lord, you are good, and beside you there is no other. God, we know what the enemy meant for evil, that you turned it around for our good. We thank you that you are God of Isaac, that you are God of Abraham, that you are God of Jacob, you are God of David. God, we thank you. We thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your kindness. We thank you for all that you are. Hallelujah. All that you've done, all that you will continue to do in our lives. God, right now we confess our faults and our sins unto you because you are faithful and you are just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all sin and all unrighteousness. Forgive us, oh God, for making anything that you've allowed us to have, anything you've even blessed us with. Forgive us for making those things our idols. Hallelujah, for serving those things, for giving those things more time, more attention, more compassion, and even more money, more resources than you. God, some of us have made those things for, made those things so precious to us that we live and breathe for those things. God, we ask for your forgiveness now, and we ask for renewing of the mind now, God. Lord, you are enough. This is Faith-Filled Friday, God, and we want the faith to believe and to act on the fact that you are enough. God, you are enough. We don't look to other things. We thank you for the husband. We thank you for the children. We thank you for the many blessings, for the businesses, for the ministries, for the ideas. God, we thank you for all of those things that you've given us, everything you've allowed our hands to touch. We thank you for everything you've allowed us to possess. God, but we don't love those things beyond you. We don't worship those things beyond you. We don't take care of it or possession over those things more than we are of you. God, we want to make that clear on this morning. And our actions and behaviors have said otherwise. We repent on this morning. That means we turn from our way and we turn toward you. God, you said that if we forgive, if you forgive us, we too have to forgive others. So God, if we're holding on to any art on this morning, we ask that you allow us to forgive now. Hallelujah, that we release it now. That we are no longer holding on to things and to people that have hurt us or wronged us. We release it now in the name of Jesus. God, I'm praying, oh God, for those of us that have had any type of contact or any type of influence or encounter, or even now with any form of witchcraft. We now know that this is a form of darkness, that these things are mind altering. They are to change the altar and the state of our mind. If there's anything outside of you, God, that is changing the state of our mind, oh God, then that means that it is the works of the devil. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bind the works of the devil on this morning. Any form of sorcery, any darkness, any demonic force, anything that we've allowed to come in our sphere of influence, anything that we've allowed to be passed down from generation to generation. We bind it now. Your word says that in order to bind the strong man, you have to first enter into his house. We enter into the house of those that are in possession of any type of witchcraft material or any type of witchcraft influence. Now we bind the strong man of witchcraft. We bind the strong man of adultery right now in the name of Jesus. These things have no power, rule, or authority over our lives. God, forgive us for dibbling and dabbling, for us wanting to know, for us having the consciousness of just being curious to know what it was, what it was like, how it feels. Oh God, we know, God, that you are enough. We don't seek anything else beyond you, God. As Matthew 6:33 tells us, we will seek ye first the kingdom of God and your righteousness, and all other things will be added unto us. God, we will not seek the things of this world. We will not allow the things of this world to be our image, to be our God, to be our
savior, to be our security, to be our answer. God, you are the answer. We believe in the blood of Jesus. We don't believe in witchcraft. We don't believe in tangible things that are representation of other things. God, yes, we make the excuse and we sometimes say, oh, well, things were done in the Bible. They did this and they did that. But the difference therein lies is when you're using something truly just for a source of medicinal purposes, or using a thing and not in connection or conjunction of it being God, Savior, or it being your deliverer. God, help us to know the difference. Your word says that we perish because of lack of understanding and a lack of knowledge. God, we come today seeking your understanding and seeking your knowledge. And if there's anything that we've been doing, anything that we've been entangled with that is against the word of God, we release it now. Even after this prayer, or even now, God, we will dispose of such things that does not represent you. We will dispose of such things if we've made those things an idol, if we've made those things our many gods, if we've utilized those things for any type of witchcraft, any type of sorcery, any type of darkness, oh Lord God, any type of rituals or routines, in the name of Jesus. The only routine we have is to pray to God the Father. Hallelujah. The only power we believe in is God the Father. The only power we believe in is the same power that had raised Jesus from the dead, that Kratos power, that explosive power. That's the power that we believe in. We don't believe in any power of any tangible thing, God, for you are all that we need. You are all that we desire. And we thank you on this morning that you are more than enough. Hallelujah. You are more than enough. In the name of Jesus, you are more than enough. It's time, God, for us to stop playing games and to let the Spirit of God really deal with us in these areas. Oh, God, if we've allowed our flesh to keep you on the run from our problems, or if we've committed to idolatry by worshiping something or someone else more than Jesus Christ, today is the day for us to stop what we're doing and to get our heart right with God. Today, we get our heart right with God. Today, we get our heart right with God. Today, we worship the Lord, the God, the Savior, the only true and living God, the only God that can save, deliver, and set us free from the hand of the enemy. Elohim, Yahweh, God, Savior, Redeemer, Deliverer, Protector, Provider. So Lord, we want to walk in your spirit and we want to mortify the deeds of our flesh. We don't want the flesh to have superior role in our life that it has had in the past. Oh God, our flesh has no authority and power. Our flesh has to be subjective under the spirit of Christ, the spirit that lives on the inside of us. Our flesh have to answer to the word of God. Our flesh does not have a life of its own. Our flesh does not have a will of its own. Our flesh is subjective to you. Our flesh has been made subjective to the Spirit of God, to the voice of God. Let us hear you, God. Let us be able to remove things that are trying to drown us out, things in the world, by way even of this pandemic, other distractions, God, that try to drown us out and try to attract and influence our flesh. But we know that in the flesh dwells, belongs, lives no good thing. And our flesh does not want to serve you. Our flesh does not want to let go of the things of this world. But we make a declaration on this morning that we know that if your spirit empowers us, we can say to the flesh and it and to its demands to control our life, we are tired of struggling with the same old sins again and again and again. So right now, God, we are asking you to help us to see the truth about what needs to change in our life. God, show us
We are all open. We are all ears on this morning. Our mind is clear on this morning. God, show us those things. God, make it clear for us. God, those people that may have been telling us or talking to us and telling us what has been wrong, the things that we've been attracted to, are entangled with. God, oh God, let us have the listening ear on this morning. Let us have the eyes, oh Lord God, with vision on this morning to see that those things are wrong. Hallelujah. God, we're asking you right now to help us see the truth about what needs to change. Once we see the problem, give us the courage to tell that work of the flesh that it is going to die. Then help us to fully embrace the new life you are wanting to release inside of us. God, there's a newness that you desire to release inside of us. We want to experience new life on today. Somebody put new life. We want to experience new life in you on today. Hallelujah. What do you have for us? God, we come to you like the empty cup before a full fountain, because we want you, Lord God. We desire you and you alone. We boldly declare that we are no longer dominated by our flesh. Say, I'm not dominated by our flesh. Instead, we walk in the power of the Holy Spirit. I need you to say, I walk in the power of the Holy Spirit. That's your affirmation on today. I am no longer dominated by the flesh. I walk in the power of the Holy Spirit. That is your affirmation. I have new life on today. Hallelujah. There is therefore no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. There's no condemnation, because today I walk in newness. Today I accept the new. Today I renew my mind. Today I renew my spirit. Today I am new in Christ. I have been made new. Hallelujah. I have been made new. I am careful, God. Lord, we are careful. Sophia is careful. Gina is careful to read our Bibles and to hear the truth that the Spirit wants to show us. God, we will read the Word of God and we will only accept the truth. And your Word is thy truth. Your Word is thy truth. God, your Word, you say you will sanctify us through the Word of God. And the Word is our truth. Oh God, when we become aware of areas that need to be changed, we quickly ask you, Jesus, to release your power to transform us, Lord God. I thank you for the releasing power of transformation. I thank you for the releasing power of transformation. Somebody say, I am transformed. Hallelujah. These are your affirmations. I am transformed. I've been made in the image and the likeness of Christ. Hallelujah. Instead of running from the truth, we run to the cross to find permanent solutions for the problems we confront along the way. God, we will run to your cross. We will not run to the world. We will not even run to our husbands, our children. We will not run to any image, any idol, any form of witchcraft. God, we run to you. You are our answer. God, you are the only answer. Somebody say, God is the only answer. You are the only answer. We don't need anything outside of you. You've already given us everything. You've already allowed us to have access to everything. You are our influencer, God. Hallelujah. You are the head of our lives, God. You are directing us, oh Lord God. You are the CEO of our lives. You're the chief executive officer of our lives, Lord. You direct us, oh God. You lead us. You guide us. You instruct us, God. We go follow your lead and follow your lead only, God. We follow your command and follow your command only. In the name of Jesus, oh God. Lord, we thank you. We declare this by faith. We pray this by faith. For it's in your Son Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah. Let the church say amen. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. God is the only answer. Hallelujah. God is the only answer. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We're going to go into our confession. Hallelujah. Our confession of faith. So fitting, since today is Faith-Filled Fridays. In Christ, we are anointed and powerful woman of God. We are joint heir with Jesus and more than a conqueror. We are a doer of the word of God and a channel for his blessings. If God be for us, who can be against us? We are blessed coming in and blessed going out. Our enemies are fleeing before us. God has commanded his blessings on our storehouses. He has opened his good treasure, and we shall lend and not borrow. We are the head and not the tail. He has given us power to make wealth. We dwell in the secret place. We have his protection and his provision. God is our refuge, our fortress. We are not afraid of the snare of the fowler. No evil shall befall us, and no plague shall come nigh our dwelling. God has given his angels charge over us to keep, and they are to bear us up in their hands, lest we dash our foot against a stone, as declared in Psalms 91. 1 Peter 2 and 9 establishes that we are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation. We are peculiar people called out of darkness, and into his marvelous light. 1 Peter 2 and 24 states that we have been healed by the stripes of Jesus. Have been is past tense. That means that healing has already taken place. If you need healing on this morning, I just need you to lift your hands, because he said that we have already been healed. He has taken healing to the cross. Whatever you need to be healed from this morning, I need you to lift your hands. I need you to cry out in spirit, not. I need you to believe, God, that you are healed from that. Whatever that is, Lord God, we are healed by the stripes of Jesus from cancer, from sugar diabetes, from heart disease, from coronavirus, from any other viruses or bacterial infection, from any and all autoimmune deficiency diseases, God. We are healed from infertility, oh God. I pray right now that our ovaries are restored, our right ovary, our left ovary, our fallopian tube, oh God, for any of us that are dealing with any form of infertility, God, I thank you. The PCOS and ovarian cysts and anything of any kind, any foreign image or object that's trying or have tried or is growing on any part of our reproductive system, in particular our ovaries, God, I declare healing right now, God, because you healed the infertile woman. You healed the barren woman, God, and anybody that may be barren, not so much in infertility, but barren in their goals, barren in their dreams, barren in their aspirations, barren, oh God, in things that you would desire for their life, bearing in their purpose, oh Lord God. Hallelujah. I pray right now for healing. I pray that we're no longer barren. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're no longer barren. We're no longer sick. Any affliction, any infection, or any other disease cannot enter into our body. And if it is, and if it does enter in our body, it shall be removed. It shall be released, because there is no foreign thing that can live inside this body, because the blood of Jesus runs in this body. His blood runs through our veins. He lives on the inside of us. And because he lives on the inside of us, nothing that's contradicting him, hallelujah, nothing that's contradicting his word can live on the inside of us. Are we as an intercessor, God, hallelujah, the righteousness of God, we are saved by the righteousness of God and washed in the blood of Jesus. We are without spot or blemish. Hallelujah. We are perfected in him. No weapon formed against us shall prosper, in every tongue which shall rise against us in judgment, we shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. We are saved from the wrath by him, and justified by the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. Lord, that we pray that we may prosper and love Jerusalem, and that peace will be with us and prosperity in our houses, according to Psalms 122, 6 through 9. God, we thank you. Hallelujah. We thank you. Hallelujah. My hair all over the place. We thank you, God, for this prayer. We thank you for this confession. Thank you for this confession. And we believe that that confession is going to be made manifest in the name of Jesus. And I stand with you, sister. You are healed from emotional, mental hurt and pain. Hallelujah. I thank you, dear Father, that you're wrapping your arms around our dear sister now. Hallelujah, Lord God. You're laying her head on your chest, God, and you're, hallelujah, you're just wrapping your arms, God. You are close to the brokenhearted, and there are many of us that have experienced mental and emotional pain from things and people that we love and we adore, that we are even once in relationships with, oh God, or somebody that was supposed to protect us and somebody that was supposed to cover us. Instead, they created harm and caused harm and pain to us, God, but we know that you are a healer, God. We know that you are a comforter, God. We know that you are our refuge. Hallelujah. And we depend on you this morning. We call you our helper, Lord God. Hallelujah. We seek you on this morning. We cast all of our cares on you, all of our worries, our anxieties, our fear, our hurt, and our pain on you. So I stand with my sister this morning. I stand in agreement, oh God, that you will cover her, oh God, and that you're providing peace unto her and whatever help that she needs to get, professional or otherwise, that she will seek that help in conjunction with seeking the word. It's okay that we have Jesus and a therapist, God. So I thank you that you will point her in the right direction, point her to the right mentor, the right coach, the right program, if that exists, oh Lord God, to be able to help her become emotionally and spiritually healed in the name of Jesus. I thank you, God, oh, for allowing us and many others to create such platforms and programs and resources and tools for these individuals to come and to access, oh Lord God, so that they can begin their healing journey. I thank you, Lord God, for your word, for your word is thy truth. And I just declare right now that the peace of God will cover you now. In the name of Jesus, the peace of God is covering you now. The peace of God is covering you now. I thank you for your peace, God. I thank you for your overwhelming peace. I thank you that peace will be so overwhelming to her, God. Hallelujah. Oh, she will have no choice but to experience it. She will have no choice but to receive it. She will have no choice but to subject herself under it. I thank you for your peace, and I thank you for every promise in your word is yes and amen. Hallelujah. And praise you, Father. We thank God this morning. Pray that you all have a beautiful and a blessed day. Listen real quick. If you have not yet gotten your planner, go get your goal achiever planner. This will help you in your day-to-day walk with the Lord. Hallelujah. This will help you write out your priorities. You have a daily production sheet. What does God say to you? What are you saying to God? Your exercise plan is in here. What are you blocking out time for? Daily prayer, completed meditation, completed daily scripture, daily reading. It asks you how you feel, your plan, daily spending, your actual spending, what you actually spent, and any savings that you may have been able to save, what you're grateful for, three affirmations. And I told you what your affirmations were today, so you have those. Visualization exercise in the next 30 days. Where do you see yourself? And then you're writing out your different priorities. So if you have not gotten that, you guys, make sure you get it. It's no longer $17. However, you can still get it because we still have a few copies left. Thanks, Jill. You still have a few copies left. So go get your copy. I think it's $27. And the regular price is $47. Regular price is $47. So go get your copy of this Goal Achiever workbook. Amen. Regular price is $47. So right now it's $27. Then the $3 of shipping, so it's $30. But I guarantee you it would be one of the best investments that you make. So if you know that you've been praying, but you know that you need to plan and prepare and persist so you can finally produce. How many of you are tired of not producing in this season? Tired of not producing. Hallelujah. Mona Lisa, is everything okay, honey? You gave me an angry face. I don't know if that was a mistake or angry at the devil. How many of you are tired of not producing? It's the third quarter of the year. Guys, we're months away from 2021. People say that this year has been a wash. I disagree. This year has been what we've allowed it to be. And if you've not taken full advantage of this year yet, there is still time. Amen. There is still time. There is still time. In the name of Jesus, there's still time. It's not a wash. It's not over. But you have to plan your life. You have to plan your day. You have to plan your month. I'm not saying you have to be such a strickler and you have to be just minute to minute because things happen. You can allow room for flexibility. But if you have nothing to go to, then where are you getting your instructions from? If you have no framework, this is a framework to help you. So if you don't have the framework, if you don't have at least a system in place, if you don't have a system in place to be able to help you, then how are you meeting your goals? How many of you are tired of not meeting your goals? And I would be remiss to say, on to that point, that our virtual conference is coming up August 6th, 7th, and 8th. August 6th, 7th, and 8th, we will be dropping the link by this weekend, early next week, for you all to register. We are looking to have an amazing time. We're going to focus on faith, finances, and fulfillment. Fulfillment being your relationships with others, your relationship with yourself. So whether that's single or married, we're going to focus on that fulfillment as in life, your life fulfillment. So we're elevating your, it's an elevate your life experience, August 6th, 7th, and 8th. It's a free event, y'all. Somebody say free. So I need you and all of your cousins, sisters, homegirls to register. We're really looking for 500 people to attend, 5 people to show up. That's a big, big goal. It's possible. It's definitely possible. Amen. Great birthday gift to you. Well, it's free. So good time to spend your birthday. Good time to spend your birthday. Free 99. Free 99. We just need you to show up. We have a dynamic lineup scheduled of people that we've carefully sorted after and looked for. We were very strategic in our selection this year, guys, and I believe that you all will be pleased. We're gonna have some opportunities for you to connect with us. It's gonna be an amazing time. I need to find something here. So that's all, you guys. Be blessed. Be blessed. If you're coming, if you plan on registering for the event, somebody say, I'm ready to elevate my life. I'll give it a minute because I know it's long. I'm ready to elevate my life. If you're coming, August 6th, 7th, and 8th, right here on the virtual space. If you're getting your workbook, just go ahead and raise your hand and go ahead to that link and get it. We still have a few copies left. That's a wrap, guys. That's a wrap. I pray that this day is amazing for you. It's Friday. Some declare this as the end of the week, but this is time to prepare for next week. Why put off tomorrow what you can do today? We're no longer putting off. We're going to be very intentional, very strategic about what God has called us to do in this time and in this season. Amen. Very strategic, very intentional about what God has called us to do. But He alone is God. Hallelujah. And He's worthy to be praised. We're intentional. And that, you know, being intentional also will help us to stay away from idolatry and witchcraft. Because when we're in the will of God, we're doing the will of God. And we're looking to do the will of God. We're not looking to do anything else outside of that. And when we're in the will of God, we're in the word of God. Because His will is what? His will is His word. His will is His word. All right, you all. So have a blessed and beautiful day and weekend. And tomorrow, for those of you that are single or that even married, Jill prays at 7 a.m. for the singles community. And I encourage you all to show up. All right, you all. Be blessed. Talk to you soon. All right. Bye.